In this video, we are going to find out how to create an expert advisor that is able to trade buy and sell trades. For this indicator, it's called the envelopes indicator. We have just opened a new position. Everything is traded automatically. It will also output buy and sell signals directly on the chart. So how are we going to code it in MQL5? To do that, please click the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template. I will call this one SimpleEnvelopeStandaloneExpertAdvisor. Click on Continue, Continue, and Finish. Let's delete everything above the onTick function and remove the two command lines here. We start by including the file Trade.mqh that comes with MQL5. And afterwards we create an instance from CTrade that is called Trade, and we are going to use it to open new positions later on. Inside of the onTick function, we need to calculate the ask price and the bid price. That can be done by using SymbolInfoDouble for the current symbol on the chart. With symbol_ask we will get the ask price, and with symbol_bid we will get the bid price. If you click on a currency pair, you will see a red and a blue line. The red is the ask price and the blue is the bid price. There are some currency pairs with 3 digits behind the dot and others have 5 digits. So we use NormalizeDouble and _digits to automatically calculate the right number of digits for the current currency pair. Now we create a string called signal. We will assign the signal later on. Right now it's empty. Let's create an array for the prices. We use MQLRates. If you mark MQLRates and press F1, you will learn that it stores the information about prices, volumes and spread, and the array will be called price information. We sort the array downwards from the current candle by using array set as series, and with copy rates we fill the price information array for the current symbol and the currently selected period on the chart. We start with the current candle 0. And we will fill it with price information for 3 candles. The envelopes indicator has 2 bands, the blue one and the red one. So we also need 2 arrays for the upper band array and the lower band array. These will also be sorted by using array set as series. And now we can create our envelopes definition by using the iEnvelopes function that is included with MQL5. This one also needs a few parameters. The first one is for the current symbol on the chart. The second one for the period we are using. It will be calculated based on 14 candles. And if you click on Insert, Indicators, Trend, Envelopes, you will see the 14 candle period here. The shift value is 0. The deviation is 0.100. And the calculation will be based on the close prices. That's exactly what we use here for the rest of the parameters. Now we use copy buffer to fill our upper and our lower band array according to the envelopes definition that we have created here. The first one will be filled for the buffer 0, the second one for the buffer 1. We start with candle 0 and copy the data for 3 candles. Let's calculate the current value for the array values. When you hover with your mouse, you will see that there is a value that is constantly changing, and that's what we need. So we look at candle 0 in the upper band array and the lower band array, and we use NormalizeDouble and a 6 to get only 6 digits behind the dot. That's what NormalizeDouble does. It's rounding floating point numbers to a specified accuracy. For the first parameter we say what we want to get rounded. The second parameter is for the number of digits we need. And if the last candle closed below the lower band, So if the close price for candle 1 in the price information is below the value for the lower band, that would be a buy signal, so we assign the word buy to our signal. Otherwise, if the close price for candle 1 in our price information array is above the upper band value, that would be a sell signal, and now we assign the word sell to our signal. And when the signal equals sell, and the function positions total is below 1, that expression will tell us that we have no open positions. And if that is the case, we use trade.sell to sell 10 microlot. In the other case, if the signal equals buy and positions total is below 1, then we use trade.buy to buy 10 microlot. Finally, we create a chart output by using the command function that will output the words the current signal is and the calculated signal. Okay, that's it. Please click on the compile button or press F7. Now you should see that you have no errors, and in that case you can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader we click on View, Strategy Tester or press Ctrl and R. Here we pick our new file, SimpleEnvelopeStandaloneEA.exe5. Please enable the visualization here and start your test. And here is our little expert advisor at work. We have already opened the first position. And now you know how to automate the envelopes indicator and how to create an expert advisor that is automatically going to trade it. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.